Production has got off to a satisfying start, but a bitter struggle for dominance in the electrical energy business is raging between George Westinghouse and his adversary, Thomas Edison. While our friend is making every effort to advance the study of alternating current, Mr. Edison favors direct current. Meanwhile, the humble minds of the people fear electricity in either form. They consider it the work of the devil. We'll ensure a glorious victory for our friend George Westinghouse in the battle against his adversary. Let's convince the people of the right system, as whoever wins the race in this war of currents will control the entire market. A gigantic generator that generates such gigantic sparks probably needs to be fed gigantic amounts of coal. Our business partner's chief tinkerer, a certain Nikola Tesla, needs tons of coal to keep the generators running for his alternating current experiments. It's urgent. Thomas Edison is entertaining sinister plans to publicly discredit Westinghouse's alternating current system. According to the rumors, a certain Harold Brown is conducting obscure experiments in his secret laboratory somewhere in Pittsburgh to bring alternating current into disrepute. Perhaps the local residents know more. Thank you. Large parts of the population still fear electricity. We must convince these people that electricity is no threat, but a blessing to mankind by providing them with a new mode of transport that will delight them all. Production volumes are growing splendidly. However, there's one small problem. The workers in our friend's factory have laid down their tools and are refusing to lift even a single finger until their demands have been met. They're calling for higher wages, shorter working hours, and better safety measures. What do we do in a case like this? A local resident has told of a crowd that was supposedly gathered around Dr. Brown, who was killing stray dogs with alternating current in order to prove its dangerous nature. Most stray dogs are said to be found in Southside. That devilish Dr. Brown is growing bolder. He's now said to be working on a chair that kills people using electric shocks. The only thing that can help is an act of sabotage. His laboratory must be destroyed. It is said to be located on the northern bank of the river.